interior designers, mm-hmm. and they had those wonderful model rooms on that floor, and everybody would go there to ooh and awe at the various styles of furnishings and the decor that was offered, and many, many people would buy it. I'd say, I want that entire room, I'll take it, you know. So little did I know that Carl Levine was the brother of my first agent,
Mark
Levin.
Yeah.
So when we went to meet with him about talking to him about whether or not Bloomingdale's would be interested in carrying some examples of Papua New Guinea cultural art, because we were representing the government of Papua New Guinea at the time.
That was you and Bill.
That was a little consortium of us. Bill, a young attorney in New York at the time, and his wife, who was my girlfriend. The four of us got involved in this amazing project. As a result of Bill's travels to and his involvement in Papua New Guinea, and him bringing me into Papua New Guinea and to appreciate the cultural arts and the magnificent oceanic carvings.
Stephanie, again. Anyway,
to make sense of what I'm just saying, we agreed with Bloomingdale's to have on exhibit and sale 300 pieces, which we then Bill and I just went back to Papua New Guinea with our machetes, literally, and hacked our way through the jungles collecting all of these magnificent pieces of art for them.
And a couple of people over there who sort of tried to charge a little more than they thought you were going to pay.
Yeah, there are some. Yeah. I hope there are some amusing stories about it covers a lot of sensitive areas for me. I hope the book is amusing. I hope it's an amusing that some of our adventures people will appreciate from just the amusement of the adventures, not only with Bill but with my mother.
Oh, she was marvelous. Traveling with her is Auntie
Mame.
She
was quite Auntie Mame. She was quite a character.
But Stephanie, you also let your heart hang out and bleed in a way with Bill's demons, his drinking, and the inability to break that cord he had with alcohol.
I'll put it in a slightly different framework. Bill's addiction to alcohol, or his propensity toward addiction to alcohol, which is also physical as well as emotional. I mean, it's as from what we know today, because addiction has been dissected today into the finite points of where it comes from, whether it can be environmental, whether it can be the propensity can be an inherited trait. Bill was afflicted with it. In his day, the notion of affliction or the notion of addiction was certainly not the way people referred to so-called heavy drinkers.
Yeah, he was one of the guys.
He was one of the guys, and everybody drank. I mean, today we watch Mad Men, and people say, oh my gosh, it's trying to replicate the 1950s. Yeah. Everybody had a drink and everybody had a cigarette, and you can... It's not an exaggeration of the way life was. It was a part of life. Ooh. So some people tolerated it, some people didn't, but it wasn't something that went, oh, horrible, you are this terrible addict. Until, for some people, it became a problem.
Yeah.
And for Bill, it became a problem.
And there is a Dr. Pesch, is that the pronoun?
Pesch.
Yeah.
Dr. Pesch.
In Palm Springs.
Well, Dr. Pesch was the doctor who looked after Betty Ford, and he was the cornerstone of the Betty Ford Clinic.
Because when he tells you, stay away, I don't know how one can do that with someone you love.
I don't agree with what Dr. Pesch prescribed.
Yeah.
I did it reluctantly, but with... with respect for this man who was bringing a new sort of light on how one can possibly treat addiction. And it was a treatment that Bill had already embraced. So I had no choice but to embrace it from my end as well. In hindsight, I would have taken Bill out of that clinic and said, "To hell with you, mister."
Yeah. Hindsight sometimes is better. Yes. Yeah. Earlier, the fun you must have had making those films with Troy Donahue and Connie Stevens and...
My life was, I don't think about my life in terms of simply, it is the life of an actor. It is that acting was a part of my life. It was one of the major ingredients in my life. And I am forever grateful to the acting profession and to my great good fortune and my luck at having been there during the last stages of the dying pains of the star system, but the doors that it opened for me, and for the exercise of my other curiosities in life, was also another component, a very strong component of my experiences.
And fortunately, all that time you had your wonderful mother with you.
Well, Mom always kept she was the ballast of the ship, you know. She always kept everything, kept me stable.
Yeah.